What I see is that the diaspora knowledge or technical support and things should be shared with Sri Lankans as well as here for the people to understand and recognize and have a personal resilience to come out and feel proud that we as a diaspora has contributed. Because we enjoy the privilege of this country, part of the big family, the democratic values of democracy, justice, peace, liberty, equality, and freedom. We also contribute to this country socially, economically, politically, and culturally. We need to be proud. We need to engage. We need to integrate. We can't simply live in ghettos and talk about politics thousands of miles away. But we need to see how best we can support each other and develop the links and networks which can be a strength to the diaspora here, as well as we can use it in back home to support our motherland, especially the things. Because if I talk about my personal story, there are many stories I hear, right? We wanted to see the successful stories should be told. I was born in a gold-owned golden village of Roombra. You never heard, but my colleague is there from Oxford University, Nick. He has been there several times and did a research on behalf of the Oxford University there. So there are many people coming from proud villages, right? We come here, we try to educate ourselves, understand the reality, and then try and help. I take this opportunity to thank the diaspora here, not only in this country, for one good reason, having the golden heart of giving. I never come across any other community who has been set an example as giving. Every single diaspora members wanted to help their motherland. He's helping their families, relatives, their old schools, their old temples, the village, orphanages, or elderly homes, and more than other things that they are going outside and help. So this is one of the things that we need to respect, and we need to see that is a big asset, the golden heart, right? I can give you a couple of examples. One of the things in Ealing Temple, right? You give money to the temple and the temple goes and gives to the community. There are many, many opportunities. But given me 5 minutes, then I can't go through the whole thing. But one of the key things is the recommendation, right? That will be published later so you can see it. But one of the saddest things is we started to call ourselves as throwies in Tamil or traitors. That has to be stopped. We need to value the humans, as Tamils, as brothers and sisters. Because for political reason or personal reason or by having a different ideology, that you can't hold other person as a traitor. There are many things that we need to understand and respect and value as a diaspora members. A couple of things that I will need to say. And then one of the important thing is to the fundraising. The Tamil assets was raised in the name of Tamils to help the Tamils. Now that when we enjoy it by different individuals. There should be a Tamil common trust should be created, and that all the assets, if they have moral values and principles and talk about Tamil's freedom, all those assets has to be transferred to the Tamil trust. Immediately 50% of the money should be sent back to Sri Lanka. When the wound is there only, you need medicine. When the wound is healed, you don't need medicine. Right? There are people, I just came back 2-3 weeks ago. I went to Wendy. First time in my life I went to Wendy. I saw the people, those who were fighting, the carders, former carders, in the hot sun and working in the farms. They didn't ask me anything. They only asked me, if you can have an opportunity, please give us an opportunity to find the jobs. Not only for them, they said there are thousands of people waiting outside. They wanted to work. They didn't ask for anything else. So this money is important. This trust is important. 50% Tamils can be the custodians, and 50% I recommend that non-Tamils should be part of the custodians in order to have a quality on that money sending process and immediately sent. Because otherwise we will be failed in our duty. There are many things that I wanted to say that because of the time factor, right, I will leave this paper with the TIC and then you can look at it. And one of the things that as a faith, we have a great faith, temple, churches, mosques, everything is there. But again, one of the things is that confusion on dates of having the rituals or celebrations here. We are following the Indian time and the Sri Lankan time and confusing the next generation here. Having two dates of Pongal, two dates of New Year, two dates of Sivaratri and all those things. It's a confusion because we need to take responsibilities. Whoever is leading, because we don't want to see that people had power. People were somebody. When these people came here, you heard the word asylum seekers. They may be a top civil servant, top executive, top family or social caste. But when they come here, they're nobody, they're nothing. They're all asylum seekers. And then gradually, then when they're recognized, they become refugees or British citizens and stuff. So for them, while they are going on those processes, they're trying to cling on to certain powers. Only place where they can show these muscles within the community. I wanted to see that they recognize the community and don't use the community. And one more important thing, the diaspora, please never ever use the children and young people in that land for fighting. No more war. War is finished. Now you try to rebuild that land with the hope of peace. Don't use the university children. I was in the hospital when those two young boys were shot dead. Right? It's so sad. We talked about standardization and various things that you need to have access to university. Now these children, the parents have worked hard to send their children to university. We sit in a comfortable life here and using them to get shot, right? We need to take moral responsibility. Simply you can't come and sit here and talk about the politics and geopolitics and international themes and terms of reference. Who are we as the diaspora? Do you have a heart? Do you have a moral responsibility? Do you have something to do before we go? That means before we die, do something good. Because we may not pass through this world again once. We need to do something. We pass through this world only once, therefore let us do something good for the benefit of the diaspora here as well as back home. Thank you.